teams were good enough to make it this far, and only four can go on. Dick Vitale and I'll find out which of these teams will complete a piece in the Final Four puzzle after today's game between the Texas A&M Aggies and the TCU Horned Frogs.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Horned Frogs are assured of a tough battle tonight, Dick. What's the key for them to succeed?
Here's what I think, Brad. First, don't give any open looks at the arc. Find the three-point shooters, baby. Second of all, don't let their big man become a factor offensively. Keep him off the block, push him away from the low box, and force him to shoot jump shots. And finally, make your team think defense first. Solid defense will lead to good offense.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. Both teams are looking to get something going here. He strips him clean. Looking for the foul. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Looking for a good shot. The shooting guard with the ball.
High post screen. Trying to go inside.
Gave it up. Got the high pick. Contact causes the shot to come off. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Number 33 fakes the shot. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Trying to feed inside. He fakes the shot.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. They look to get it to the inside. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam. Nice high post screen.
In and out. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Blocks the shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Pull-up jumper from way out. Off the rim and no good. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
And he can't hit the shot. Three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Dumps it in. That wide stance and the drop step.
I tell you, it's all about angles, and if you utilize that drop step, it's like a reverse pivot move.
The power forward gets the pass. Kicks it out. He shoots from outside. Way off target. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Pump fakes. Gave it up. Gets the ball and now faces his man down on the low block.
A very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position at the post.
He tries the three. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Puts it up looking for contact.
That's basic.
Trying to draw the foul. And he scores despite the hack. On the dribble, gives it up. Bland is feeling great right now.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
Leans in. Patterson makes the finger roll. Yeah. Doesn't go. On the outside. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position of spreading his body and getting the ball.
Launches the three, and he misses the shot. This zone is shutting down this offense almost entirely.
All the gaps are covered, and guys are talking out there.
The ball goes out of play. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
Working it around the perimeter. Nice drop step.
I tell you, he does a great job with his footwork to create the drop step.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, it's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. First one is good.
Makes those free throws count. Wants to go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
For two. Basket falls despite the contact. Both teams looking to get things going here. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Now they work it around the perimeter. The power forward takes the feed. Grace makes a great move to draw the foul. He is going to the line. First one is no good. Misses the second shot. He gets the rebound. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Jumps in. He puts it in with contact and all.
Great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
On the outside, the shooting guard gets the ball. Too much. That's a foul. And, Dick, look at this sellout crowd, and they are loving it.
Oh, they're ecstatic, baby. They're ecstatic. Great team play.
They will line them up. He gets it to go. Gets two at the charity stripe.
Up and inside.
He strokes it off the rim and no good.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Bland pounded on his way up. Those are the types of plays you want a lot of. These kids are on a roll. Look at them celebrating with one another.
Hey, can you blame them, Brad? They're playing well.
At the free throw line. Opportunity. Hits that one. Good defense, a steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
Gets it back out. The point guard takes the pass. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
He grabs the rebound. And the ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
The post flashes up high if he wants it. For the bucket, Texas A&M are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, they gotta keep pushing and seeing if they can't force a timeout.
They'll work it around the arc. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
And I think right now, got to focus defensively.
Looking for a good shot. He gets the foul off the pro hop. He was going full steam ahead on that move. He'll go to the line. He gets it to go. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
Both free throws go. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
On the outside. From left of the circle. Sinks it. He's going to see this guy in his sleep tonight, Dick.
He's already living the nightmare, Brad.
For two, they're just having a devil of a time getting good looks at the hole.
That's right, Brad. I haven't seen a whole lot of plays carried out and executed the way they should be.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
It's stolen.
Let's see if they go two for one here, Brad.
The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting the good inside angle, a poor job defensively, no help. I mean, that is post play at its best.
Well, the defender goes down, but there's no call either way.
Wow, no call right there.
And that bucket's going to count plus one.
A big time and one, baby.
With the freebie. Rims out. He gets the board. They work it around the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown. He makes the shot. There's a double team waiting there. This guy's not looking for anybody else up there.
You're right, Brad. He's got a little too much to prove right now.
At the half, the Aggies lead by 11. Thus far, it's been a tightly contested game, Dick. What's your highlight of the first half?
Check out some of the inside play we witnessed in the first half. We saw some great baskets down low, which really opened up the outside range for both teams.
Well, let's head back down to the court for the start of the second half. TCU seemed to have just unraveled from the field, Dick.
What a terrible shooting display out there. I mean, it was horrible. Everything about their offense was terrible, if you ask me.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron.
Inside.
Had him in the low block, but opted against it. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to go. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He gets the shot to fall.
Coming inside.
Ooh, look at the shot block. We got some contact. Nice hops.
Tears it away.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way to be able to get some fast break opportunities.
From downtown, he hits the shot. Gave it up. Here's a double team. On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
To the action. Entry pass in the paint. A high screen. And the ball goes out of play. Like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Oh, I don't know about that call.
That's one of those plays where I think the ref anticipated the foul and blew it down on instinct. Just play, son. Just play. Let your game do the taunting.
He goes to the free throw line. Makes the first shot. TCU are doing a nice job of pulling a solid run together here.
Hey, they're really starting to clip an offense.
Second one, good.
That's 14 unanswered.
That was a definite blow to one team's composure. Let's see how or if this will affect the team. For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket. That's worth another look.
Was like a NASCAR wreck and no whistle.
Wow, no call. You like that NASCAR? Hey, where's Mr. Petty?
Picked off. The Horn Frogs have a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch. I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it, but I can hear it clearly down here. The coach is stressing, go inside, go inside. They've been affected all night long that way. What an asset to have, guys.
All right, Erin, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
I tell you, Erin's exactly right. Post play is essential if you're going to be effective. This defender is resilient, still applying pressure. Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He shoots from left of the circle. Rims out. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Rejects it.
He's a high riser. Sensational, baby.
He comes up empty. Jumped in front to take it away. Goes up for two. Off the rim and no good. Takes away the pass. Looking for a good shot.
Coach looks on. Focused. A lot of intensity. A lot of emotion. Screen was there, but the shot didn't fall.
They're working around the arc. Time to pick up the defense here now. Intercepted. They're working around the perimeter. He missed the guy in the post and goes the other way. From right in the circle, rims out. Moving it around the perimeter. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Bland makes the finger roll.
Hey, this crowd will be ecstatic if they can get a basket.
On the outside. He shoots from left of the circle.
If they can get off some good shots and easy buckets, they might turn around this awful stretch of shooting for them, Brad.
Easier said than done, though, right now, Dick.
Man, he ran his man right into the screen to get off that nice jumper.
Dick, we had a great tournament game going on in the first half. I don't know what happened here in the second half, but it's not even close anymore.
Well, I think it's a lot going to get down to coaching on both sides. I think the coach's strategic maneuvers here are going to be the difference, making sure that they make certain that their star player gets the ball in the right place of the court, because so many times guys are pushed away from their point of emphasis.
He shoots from the baseline. He's not letting the game come to him at all.
Yeah, Brad, he's trying too hard to build a one-man show. He's taking the game away from his other teammates. Come on, man, get with the team. Get him.
He gets the layup to go and the foul.
What a hoop. He saw the defender coming and tried to go right through him. I tell you, what an opportunity he's got right here. Because to me, this is a gift.
He looks at the hoop.
Double team now, bad angle.
Gave it up. Chapman receives the ball. Block shot. Patterson handles the feed. Pushes it up with a quarterback pass. Easy one.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
On the dribble, gives it up. This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Lane handles the pass. He strips him clean. Gave it up. The point guard receives the pass. Picks off the lazy pass. For the deuce, TCU. They have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
He fires from long range. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
Dick
Dick, he's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He buries it.
You don't get any points for the replay, but it still looks great. Nice fake.
Number 32 with the fake. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
He shoots from the top of the key. The Aggies have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brad, he's on fire.
Pass is thrown down court.
They need a basket here to turn this into a two-possession game.
Nelson is trying to get the crowd involved now.
He wants everyone up for the next possession. They got a foul quickly here.
Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right time.
Shot clock is dead. On the outside. He shoots from outside. They can't find the range right now behind the arc.
They should start looking elsewhere. Maybe try and get an easy one inside.
Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
And the clock stopped with a foul. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession or timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Nick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I'll tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
Turnovers, Dick, they just kill you every time.
I'll tell you, Brad, they sure do. You must keep the number to a minimum in order to maximize your number of shot attempts. I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Second shot is good. Prayer. No good. Dick, I think the better team won, we can say that, and it's heartbreak for the other club, but, you know, you got to win it, keep on going to get that final Monday night in April.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball, they made sure they converted on the free throw line, they did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The Horned Frogs takes care of business in this fourth round game.
Well, I'll tell you, Brad, they just proved they have too many weapons to be denied the big W. They'll have to continue to play like this as they face some of the stiffest competition in quest of the Final Four.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.